Hello everyone, how's it going? Are you 50 or older? You may be wondering if you should get the vaccine to help protect yourself from getting shingles. There are actually 1 million people in the United States that get shingles every year, and it's very painful. But you may be wondering too, well, what are the side effects to the vaccine, and how much protection does it give? If that sounds interesting to you, then keep watching. So when you get shingles, you usually develop a rash on one side of the body or the face. It actually starts with red bumps and it turns into fluid-filled blisters that can last 3 to 5 weeks. Now it sounds a lot like chickenpox, which makes sense because shingles is actually caused by a reactivation of the same virus that causes chickenpox. Now more than 99% of Americans who were born on or before 1980 have had chickenpox. So the CDC actually recommends adults 50 years and older to get 2 doses of the Shingrix vaccine. That is an FDA-approved vaccine. You would get 1 dose, and then 2 to 6 months later, you would get your second dose. It's also recommended for adults who are 19 years of age or older if they have a weak immune system. Now, the vaccine actually boosts the body's protection against shingles, and it helps your immune system to actually be able to defend against it. It's actually proven to be over 90% effective for adults 50 years of age and older if they have a healthy immune system. The immunity actually stays strong for 7 years after vaccination. Now you could still get shingles even though you've been vaccinated, but it should reduce the severity and the duration. So the Shingrix vaccine is non-living, so you don't have to worry about being contagious to others while taking the vaccine. The live vaccine is actually no longer available in the United States. If you had the live vaccine, it was called Zostavax. It's still recommended for you to get the new vaccine because it's so much more effective. It's even recommended to get this vaccine if you've already had shingles. Now before we move on, I'd like to just remind you to please like and subscribe if you're enjoying today's video. I appreciate your support. So the main 2 reasons people are hesitant to get the vaccine is that, one, they're concerned about the adverse side effects, and number 2 is they are actually concerned about the cost. Now, most insurance does cover the vaccine, but you would want to check with your insurance carrier just to make sure what you might possibly be responsible for out of pocket. Now, as far as the reaction to the vaccine, the most common is pain, redness, swelling at the injection site, muscle pain, tiredness, headache, shivering, fever, and upset stomach. The side effects are more common in younger people, but most people can take some ibuprofen or Tylenol, and then within 2 to 3 days, those side effects will go away. I would like to know about your experience. Have you received the vaccine for shingles? If so, which one did you receive, and did you have any side effects? Let me know in the comments below. There is a risk of getting Guillain-Barre syndrome, which is a nervous system disorder. It is very rare, but there's even a small increased risk after having shingles of getting this syndrome. The comforting thing is that for every 1 million people who receive the vaccine, only 1 or 2 actually experience any serious side effects. So it's not recommended for people who are allergic to any of the components of the vaccine, if they currently have shingles, if they're pregnant, or they have a moderate to severe illness. If they just have like a minor cold, they could get the vaccine, but anything else, you'd want to recover from your illness first. So this is really something for us to consider seriously. You know, as we age, our immune system declines, and so we're more susceptible to get shingles. 1 in every 3 people will get shingles. The most common complication to shingles is actually the concern that it could lead to PHN, which is postherpetic neuralgia. And that's where people describe feeling a burning, jabbing, aching, where they had the rash. The nerves will bother them sometimes. It could last for weeks. Other people, it lasts for months. Other people, even years. And it's very difficult to treat. So talk with your doctor and see what he would recommend if he thinks the vaccine might be right for you. I hope you've enjoyed today's information, and I hope to see you in the next video. where we'll discuss another way we can improve our health.